true. It's the number one cause of death in women. Sometimes women's symptoms can be a little different. They don't have the typical chest pain. A lot of times they're simply present with shortness of breath. Unfortunately, that's not true. I think having a strong family history is more concerning. It should be tested earlier. But clearly we see plenty of patients who have no history and come in and they have coronary disease or other heart problems. Young people are at risk, especially people with strong family histories or some other issues, or if they smoke and don't take care of themselves. Not the only way, but they help. So eating a good portion controlled diet, minimizing your calories, minimizing the alcohol. But if you can walk 20 minutes, a half hour a day, every day, maybe some light weightlifting, I think that will clearly help you. But there are other things being, in addition, the preventative stuff, like making sure your blood pressure is under control and your diabetes is under control and your cholesterol. No. That's why high blood pressure is called the silent killer. We see people in, you know, they say, well, I have no medical problems, but they walk in and their pressure is 180 over 120. That strain on your heart is not good. No, you should exercise for sure. You could start out small. Walking 10 minutes a couple times a day is good. So we're not asking people to run marathons, but you do need some level of physical activity. Unless you have risk factors, known risk factors, like a high calcium score or had a prior heart attack, just for what we call primary prevention of coronary disease, it's not indicated. So again, it should be discussed with your primary care provider.